Welcome to a special edition of our weekly Corkine Q&A. Every Wednesday, 8 p.m. Eastern, right here on YouTube, I answer a ton of Corkine-related questions from readers and viewers just like you, live on YouTube. But I know not everybody can make our weekly Corkine Q&As. They have church events, sporting events, gymnastics, whatever it may be, that they can't be there. So I asked on Facebook and Twitter this week, what Corkine questions do you have? And I want to answer some of the more common ones I got in this video and in videos going forward in the future. Now, we'll still be doing the weekly Corkine Q&A videos live every Wednesday, 8 p.m. Eastern, but we're going to throw in some of these special edition ones on top of it. So if you're new here, hit that subscribe button, hit that thumbs up, it really does help us. And if you have a question you can't make the live Q&A, leave it here in the comments and I may be able to answer it in a future video. Let's dive on in there. First of all, James asks one of the more common questions I get. Should you get a Roku TV? Or should you just buy a Roku player? And to me, this really comes down to, do you have a TV you're happy with? If not, then maybe it is time to buy a Roku TV. But if you have a TV that works great, you're very happy with it, there's no reason to go buy a new TV. I would just buy a Roku player for less than 100 bucks, call it good. Performance-wise, they're very similar. Roku's high-end mid-range TVs are very similar to a Roku Ultra. Now, Roku TVs do offer additional features that the Roku players don't. Really great integration for over-the-air TV with an antenna. You can even pause and play live TV through it. It's got a channel guide for over-the-air TV that looks really great, allows you to look into the future for free. Roku has really done a great job of making it easy to access multiple inputs. They appear like channels right in your Roku menu. So if you need a new TV, though, I would say Roku TVs are a great option for Corkiners. If your primary function is streaming, some antenna, I don't think it can be a Roku TV. And honestly, if your budget's under $1,000, the Roku TCL 6 series is the best TV for under $1,000 I've tested this year for 2018. Now, yeah, you can get better TVs if you're willing to pay $2,000, $1,500, whatever. If you want to pay more, there's better TVs out there. But under $1,000, the Roku TVs is really doing a great job there. Now, a few things to remember with this is you're not going to be able to get a DVR built into a Roku TV. A lot of people have asked me that question. No, there are no Roku TVs. The play pause feature on the Roku TVs just does that. Plays and pauses live TV through an antenna. You can get additional DVRs like a Tableau DVR, a TiVo, a Channel Master, and more, and plug them in and use it that way. But that's a common question I get when people look at these TVs. So if you have a TV, you're happy with it, get the Roku player. It's a great option, save you a lot of money. If you need a new TV, time to upgrade to a 4K one, time to replace a broken one, don't be afraid to check out the Roku TVs. They're seeing a huge growth in market share, and I think the quality of them has really gone up in the last couple of years. All right, question number two comes from Jimmy, and he asks about the new 3.0 over-the-air TV standard and asks, will it do a better job having better range? Will it cover a larger chunk of land for each tower out there? So if you're not familiar, ATSC, I can't remember which way it goes, 3.0 is the new over-the-air TV standard. It's replacing the 1.0 standard we have now. We skip 2.0, go right to 3.0. And it brings a lot of features, 4K, better sound, better features like on-demand content, better emergency weather notifications, and it also, theoretically, in testing so far, has a better job of covering a range. Now, that doesn't mean you're going to get no channels to a ton of channels. What does mean if you live on a fringe of an area where it kind of gets signal, it kind of doesn't, or maybe you're just outside of it, you may be able to now get over-the-air TV where you didn't before. And I think the people who really win here is, like, I have an ABC affiliate with my ACK antenna. It does a pretty good job picking it up, but the indoor antennas just can't quite lock into that NBC station. I think people like that will be successful. Now, there are some catches here. Now, a lot of people say, oh, back in the 70s and the 80s and the 60s, everybody got over their TV. It was great. And that's not necessarily true. Not everybody got over their TV. And I think one of the things that's really happened in the last 30 years is people have moved out farther and farther into suburbs and rural areas, and they're farther away from transmitters. You look at neighborhoods built in the 60s and 70s, you notice they're much closer to major city centers. They're also like much smaller lots on average, not all, there's exceptions here. They're a lot smaller, they're a lot lower to the ground and closer to major cities. Well, when you're closer to a major city, you're closer to the transmitter that's broadcasting it. So now that we're in more rural areas, we're farther away. I think it's sometimes we have to remember that we're no longer what we used to be back in the 60s. I mean, think about the 50s, a lot of people still lived in major cities, and then you had more farmland out there in more rural areas. Well, a lot of that farmland is now homes. So just keep in mind, I don't want to promise this idea that everybody's suddenly going to get signal. What I do think is it really will do a better job for people living in fringe areas, people who live in suburbs where it kind of is and kind of isn't a signal. I think that's when you really get the benefit of the 3.0 standard. So when will this happen? Wouldn't be surprised to see some commercial rollouts in 2019. 2020 is the target by most major networks. They're kind of saying it's going to happen. We're expecting to see 3.0 Roku or 3.0 TVs, excuse me, coming out in 2019. So keep an eye out for that to happen. But once they start rolling out with the 3.0 TVs and the 3.0 transmitters, two things remember. You don't need a new antenna. You may need a new tuner for a TV, whether that be like a little HDMI stick where you plug your antenna in and plugs in your TV to get the 3.0. Antenna is basically a dumb piece of metal. And like all metal, it picks up signal from radio waves. And then that tuner in your TV is what says, hey, ignore AM, FMs, ignore all kinds of CB radios or whatever, and just focus on whatever frequency that TV channel you want is on. That tuner is what's going to be changing. Now, when the FCC approved this, they said if you transition your TV station to 3.0, you have to continue to broadcast in 1.0 for 5 more years. With 2020 being the target date, that means we're probably not going to see TV stations shutting off their 1.0, their current standard, until 2025. So about 6 years from now, we may see that. The other thing is I do expect to start seeing newer TVs in 2019 and 2020 come out with the new 3.0 standard. So if you don't want to upgrade, it's very possible that your current TV's lifespan will continue to go just fine, no issues. Reality is we all think, oh yeah, our TVs are going to last forever. They probably won't. But I do think that when that transmission comes, most people will have newer TVs that will have it built in. If they don't, everybody's been talking about these adapters in the $30 to like $60, $70 range, where you just buy this little either box. Some people are talking about like little adapter boxes for 3.0 with DVRs built in, kind of offering that as an option. Other people are talking about like HDMI, like sticks, like a Roku stick or a Fire stick with a coaxial cable on the back. Connect your antenna, plug it into the TV. Now you have 3.0 TV with the 4K and all the benefits of it. So just keep that all in mind, that there are new features coming. I wouldn't panic by having to replace your expensive brand new TV. I don't think that's be an option. Either you're probably going to get one naturally in the future, or you can just get one of these small adapters. Your antenna won't need to change. It's just the tuner in the TV. And I really do think the 4K, the better signal penetration, the additional features, better sound, will offset any pain of having to upgrade. All right, next question up. It comes from Alita. I hope I pronounced that right. I apologize if I did not. Says, I don't have any OTT streaming services at this moment. I want to watch Hallmark Countdown to Christmas that's starting this weekend. Sorry, that was actually last weekend from when I'm recording this. What's the cheapest way to watch in DVR? Because it's a little too early for me. If you really want a service with DVR that's cheap, you should look at Philo. It's a AT&T watch is $1 cheaper, but doesn't include DVR. And Philo gives you like 30 other channels or 20 some channels. I can't remember what it is. Some really good channels for $16 with a DVR built in. So if the cheapest way possible to watch the Hallmark channel for Christmas, I would look at Philo. It also includes Hallmark drama, Hallmark movies and mysteries on top of the typical Hallmark channel with that. The other part is with it is I will put a link down in the show notes because like Sling TV, DirecTV Now, and others offer the Hallmark channel. I'll offer a full guide to that in the show notes down below. All right, last question. This comes from Michael. When will cable companies go the way of dinosaurs? And I get this so often, let's answer it again. So when cable companies come to an end? I'm not really sure they ever will. I always think there may be a place for premium a premium experience, first class in an airline, business class, and so on. Maybe people will pay a premium price if they think they can get a premium product. But I do expect in the next 5 years that cable will be dramatically different than it used to be. Now, it's important to remember that we don't know what the future looks like. There were some analysts that came out last year with some crazy, I mean, crazy huge predictions that cord cutting would quadruple in size, all that kind of stuff, you know, exaggerating a little bit. And now people are like, oh, look, these analysts said this, and it's not quite that big. Well, cord cutting may not be as big as some crazy analysts said it would be, and now cable companies are trying to use that to say cord cutting is over. But you look at like AT&T reporting their numbers last week, they lost over 300,000 subscribers in just 3 months from their traditional pay TV services. When you look at that, that's over 100,000 a month. That is the largest loss of pay TV subscribers ever in the history of AT&T. So I do think that cord cutting is growing faster than ever. I think cord cutting is doing really well, but the economy is good. And that may slow down cord cutting a little bit because there's not the need to go save money if you're getting a pay raise or getting a better job. So keep that in mind. But I do think cable will be dramatically different. I think we'll start seeing some smaller companies, cable companies, fold first, get absorbed into bigger ones, and the story repeats. Will we, in my lifetime, completely eliminate all cable or traditional satellite, etc.? Probably not, because there's still people who live in extremely rural areas that count on Dish or DirecTV for their TV. Dish is really, I've been listening to Sirius XM, and I hear the commercials about how they're the small town service now. And they're really trying to sell it to small towns where, you know, where there's no stoplights and the internet is not that great, basically, is the commercial. So I think there is an argument that we're not going to completely get rid of it. I think it'll be dramatically smaller, dramatically different, maybe a premium service, a service for people who live in areas where internet's still not an option. The wireless services, internet services will be eating into that in the next 5 years, but it's not going to happen overnight. So keep that in mind. But I do think in 5 to 10 years, we'll see a very different internet or pay TV and internet situation. But I don't think pay TV or cable and satellite is going to be completely gone in the next 5 to 10 years. Well, there you go. My top five questions, or four questions that I got from people right now. If you have one that I didn't answer, you want to answer, you can't make the live Q&A, leave me a comment down below. I'd love to hear from you. And maybe in a future video, I'll be able to answer your question. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. Hit that thumbs up.